As we approach 2025, it's time once again to look ahead and predict the key trends or developments most likely to define the coming year for AI in the private sector. And let's start with the biggest one, AI agents. You'll recall that an AI agent is a system that uses AI to do three things: perceive its environment, process the information it gathers, and take action to achieve goals based on that information. That could be in the form of a personal assistant like Alexa or Siri, or it could be an automated financial trading system or a self-driving car. Those are all agents. And since OpenAI is positioned to be a key player in this, let's study them as an example of why this is on track to be a key trend. Currently, OpenAI has 250 million weekly active users, according to this post that ran over the weekend in the Financial Times. And the story goes on to quote leadership there as hoping to attain a billion users next year by offering AI agents that help people in their day-to-day tasks. Here's how this plays out. As we know, OpenAI raised more than $6 billion in October, which was done at a $150 billion valuation, by the way, which is the highest for any startup in the history of Silicon Valley. And they plan to raise even more money, including both debt and equity. So, where's that money going? In addition to further work on the Orion models, the company says that they plan to build clusters of data centers in the Midwest and Southwest, similar to Google and Amazon. So, add it all up, they're spending over $5 billion a year and are not even close to breaking even. But as several of the founders and key executives went out a side door recently, more than 2,000 new employees came in through the main gate, increasing headcount over there 5x over last year. And those new hires now include many people who are experts in building and monetizing consumer products, which is a new skill at the company. It works like this. As OpenAI doubles down on long-term investments in R&D and infrastructure, they need cash flow to sustain that. And that's where the agents come in. We actually have three things going on here. First, the technology for agents is ready now. Everyone in the industry, including investors, can see that. As we head into 2025, it's really possible now to build agents that are quite useful for everything from booking travel to buying gifts for family and friends. A whole array of services that people would be willing to pay for. Second, OpenAI needs to monetize that capability in order to keep investing at its current pace, in order to keep its leadership position. And it has already assembled a team that intends to do just that. And third, they've inked a deal with Apple, which gives them access to 2 billion owners of Apple products. And that rollout already began last month. And that's why some analysts say that OpenAI could actually achieve its aspirational goal of a billion users in the coming year. And if you hit a billion users, you're in the same class with Facebook and Google. Meanwhile, Microsoft, Anthropic, and Google have also announced plans to launch AI agents of their own in the coming year. Elon Musk, too. He plans to launch a robo-taxi service and a humanoid robot next year. And he raised $6 billion to launch XAI. Add it all up, you can see that AI agents of various sorts are lining up to be a defining part of the AI landscape for next year. So, that's one. Another trend we'll see is further advances in generative AI, including multimodal applications that process images, audio, or video, as well as text. For example, AI can develop a much more cohesive understanding of a person's emotions if it can process video of facial expressions, plus audio for tone of voice, along with the transcription of the conversation itself. That's just one example of an emerging use case for multimodal Gen AI. But let's use that for illustration purposes. We have three components here: analysis of facial expressions, recognizing tone in an audio recording, and sentiment analysis of text. All three of these have already been well researched, and each one has been successfully used in areas like customer service or mental health monitoring or virtual assistants that are trained to be sentiment aware. But the integration of these into a single unified system is currently still a work in progress. And yet many companies, including OpenAI, Google, and Microsoft, are investing heavily in multimodal AI. And edge devices are also improving rapidly. We have better cameras, better microphones, and more effective real-time processing capabilities. So it's quite plausible that this use case will see early commercial applications in the market already next year. So that's number two. On the other end of the spectrum, another important trend we'll certainly see in the coming year will be a proliferation of lightweight models that perform well on edge devices at low cost. Already, the cost of inference on top models has fallen by 10x this year. But meanwhile, even lighter weight models can now be built in a couple of months with half a dozen engineers, and those can be priced at about 3% of the latest cost for top models. So you can imagine what that will do for market size. So that's number three. Finally, in the area of robotics, we've already seen numerous use cases that go beyond repetitive manufacturing tasks. For example, we've seen technology that delegates things like inspecting structural integrity at heights for bridges or tall buildings or wind turbines or power lines. Technology like that can be purchased from companies like Skydio or DJI. And there are also climbing or walking robots like Boston Dynamics Spot, or robots that extend human capabilities like Sarcos Guardian XT. There are also robots that replace humans for dangerous work like cleaning the inside of oil storage tanks or for cleaning up a nuclear disaster site. Problem is, some of those technologies are quite expensive still, which limits adoption to very high-risk situations or large-scale industries. But costs are coming down, and so many of these use cases will see a faster pace of adoption in the coming year. So, to summarize, we have proliferation of AI agents, further advances in generative AI, including multimodal applications, adoption of lightweight models that perform well on edge devices at low cost, and new or expanded use cases in robotics that go beyond repetitive manufacturing tasks. Now, of these, I predict that most of the hype and media attention will be on the first two, because those are applications of AI that directly affect business and consumers alike. And the high-profile launches from each of the tech giants will get plenty of media coverage and also generate lots of user feedback. By contrast, although the emergence of lightweight, low-power models will be an important enabling development, it's not as sensational. So probably that will be a trend that gets less attention on mainstream media. And finally, in the area of robotics, we're on track to see some remarkable milestones in the coming year. And robotics has always been a staple topic in AI news. But still, it's likely that those developments will also get less attention than the first two categories, simply because the field of robotics has a slower adoption curve than apps do, for example. So, there you have it, a look into the future of AI for the coming year. Meanwhile, thanks for watching and see you next time.